Hey guys, Hanzo here from Devoted Gaming, and this is Bladestorm, the Hundred Years War. Hey guys, welcome back to the walkthrough. We're still here in Incursion into Flanders, after escorting the Duke of Lancaster to his destination. Now we have to work our way to complete the main objective. Which is easier if you try to take the surrounding towns, so that more towns are attacking your objective. Let me grab my lucky pole sword unit here. Come, man, we can actually fight this time. That unit. There they are. No disadvantage, but one cavalry unit. They can't stop me. Go. Rush down. Ow. That didn't really hurt. Hello. Yeah, well, horses just, like, block them so they can't move, and then just go to town on them. Oh, wait. When they're charging, just chase after them after they run past you, and then they will usually circle around. There you go. Let's take that town, shall we? Oh, it's a castle. Let's take that castle right now, shall we? Good job. And without my help, I'm so proud of my English forces. This castle only has one more base point left, so I take down these swordsmen, the base commander shall appear, and I don't have to wait for the army itself. We got some lady fences, but I'm not too worried. Even though it's a disadvantage, I'm not worried. My pole sword's gonna be fine. Oh no, I'm so not worried still. I'm alone! Still not worried. Best class ever, pole swords. Even though at a disadvantage, because of their defenses being so high, it doesn't really... They take a long time to die. Ooh, there's a lot of horses over there. I'm just gonna run past you, if you don't mind, and head to that village or castle and take it, and hopefully I can go to the objective from there. Who is that? Marie! She's a lady fencer. And she's weak against sword. Perfect. You guys were correct. But I'm worried Marie, even though she's at a disadvantage, I think she's at a really high level. She's level 21, so she's still gonna be a threat. So be careful. Get out, Marie. She fell down again. Stay still. Come on, Marie. Don't raise your shield. Put it down. No? Fine. Not Rebecca should summon the base commander after defeating this unit. Get up. Base commander, yay. Oh, he's coming to me. Perfect, I can ignore those spear guys. Come on. And of course I get Bladestorm now when I don't need it. Oh, I'm wasting it. Spear guys, oh, I can't use them. Dang.
Who can rush into battle fast?
Ooh, dual swords. And it looks like I did not put Bladestorm into good use because it just ran out. Who is that? Krishna? Krishna? Whatever your name is, you're gonna die now. Oh, they used curved scythe. Weapons. That's pretty cool. I'm just village too. One more base point, right? Yes, well, looks on the map. One more base point. And I get Lady Fencers, who are weak against my swords. Perfect. There we go. And by taking this castle, I have two castles attacking my objectives. Perfect. Makes things a lot easier. Where are you going? There. I laid all the footwork down. Just left is the objectives. Let's take the one on this side first of the water.
Come with me.
Ooh, my axe are still under leveled. I should level them up. I wish they ran faster. It's so slow. I'm falling asleep. I'm getting there slowly but steadily. I'm getting there. And it's all red. That's always lovely. Let's sneak around back. Aw, oh, time's up. It's okay. I did a lot during this day. All red. But you know, of time ticking down, I don't really care at this point. So go. Come to me. Go. Pull out a whirlwind. protection. Or destroyed most of the fencer unit. Anyway, time's up though. But I laid all the groundwork down, so the next part should be pretty easy. Maybe I even have time to squeeze it in the next part. I'll have to start another video. Let's see. I'm gonna check my timing and I'll be right back. I am back, and I think I can squeeze in the last two objectives in this part and not make it a long video, so I'm gonna try my best. Quickly take the last objective on this side of the water. That way I have two castles attacking that one on that side. Grab my lady fencers, because they are fast moving units, so I can get there faster. And I'm just hoping, fingers crossed, that I have an advantage over a unit, so I can use these fencers and level them up. One disadvantage. I'm not too worried. Go. They're stuck behind the archers anyway. Their sword unit. I have some charm. Come on, ladies. Keep poking and stabbing. He will eventually go down. Good job. And I didn't lose a single lady. Let's sneak around back. Yeah. Actually... Yeah, never mind. Wait for backup. And sneak in the back and get those pole sword units. Go! Oh no. They're dying. Okay, we're gonna clear this unit first before I lose all of them. Spears! Perfect! Cavalry, leave me alone. Good. This spear unit could be very devastating when they throw javelins up close like that. They hardly miss. And of course I miss right afterwards. Oh, hello. There we go. Now we can cross the river and take the last objective. Yeah, I'll skip those guys. Because they're about to run into another group. I'm gonna see who's on the bridge. And all I see is red. Okay, change of plans. Let's attack that group instead from the rear. Hopefully I can get a javelin and get rid of those horses. That time it just right. They're running away, perfect. Take out their friends. Well, here they are. Go! Stunned. And... javelin to the face. all disadvantage, but I'm not worried, I just took out cavalry. See, cavalry is useless once they are stunned. Full swords? Eh, I'm just gonna run past them. Comes another unit. What do we have in this group? One disadvantage. Eh. Go! Full swords, great. Never mind, Bladestorm. They can't do anything to me, so get out of the way, please. Let's do some more damage with this. I just ripped those guys apart. There we go. There we go, all done.
You deserve no praise for simply doing your job.
That is not fair. I deserve some praise. I did all the work. That wasn't a lot of money, huh? That was super disappointing.
I hear there was an assassination attempt on England's Duke of Lancaster.
He is unharmed, though, is he not? I understand his bodyguard is quite extraordinary. Apparently, the bodyguard is an assassin who once targeted Prince Edward, no less.
Using a former assassin as a bodyguard. A most effective ploy, I would agree.
Yes, I agree as well. Thanks for watching, you guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. This is Hanzo signing off.